As a culture, we are obsessed with levitation, whether it's skateboards, cars, trains, bikes, or even people. Unfortunately, most of the obvious examples here are works of fiction or trickery. Magicians used deceptive angles, Star Wars used mirrors, Total Recall used go-karts, and Looper used a pickup truck. But Lexus recently introduced a real hoverboard, and while it's impractical and mostly a marketing gimmick, the technology behind it could actually lead to faster trains, more energy-efficient cars, and hoverboards that, well, actually hover. This is Professor Matthew Sullivan. He's a humble scientist at Ithaca College. A few years ago, Professor Sullivan got a call from a producer asking him to come on the Colbert Report. Why? Well, Colbert wanted to prove that his flavor of ice cream was more futuristic than Jimmy Fallon's. And, as it turns out, Professor Sullivan knows how to make things levitate. For real.
Ladies and gentlemen, Dr. Matthew C. Sullivan.
Whoa! Engage.
It's levitating!
What you're seeing is quantum levitation, the same science that Lexus uses for its hoverboard. And it's all made possible by superconductors.
This is a superconductor right here.
At room temperature, the superconductors we have today aren't that interesting. But
if you get them cold enough, for example, if you immerse them into liquid nitrogen, the electrons in this material enter a new state, the superconducting state.
Basically, some superconductors have unique magnetic and electrical properties. If they're cooled in a magnetic field, they'll hold on to that magnetic field.
The technical term is pinned in place.
And the result is levitation. In addition to levitating right side up,
you can also run it on the side
or upside down, and the superconductor will stay at the exact same distance from the track. It is locked in place. That is, until it warms up.
Uh-oh.
You may have seen some other types of hover technology recently. There's the Hendo hoverboard, and then there are maglev trains, like this one that was recently built in Japan. But they're different.
They all use magnetic fields generated from electric currents above a metal sheet or a metal track to levitate above that piece of metal.
So that super fast maglev train in Japan, while it's an amazing progression in mass transit, it's not the end game for magnetic transportation because it still requires a decent amount of power to create the magnetic field required for it to levitate.
This is different in that once you get the superconductor cold, you don't need any external power supply to keep it above the track and to keep it suspended on the track and to keep it guided along the track. The superconductor will do all that for you.
Imagine you get on a train in New York City, and in 1 hour, you're in Washington, D.C., over 200 miles away. And you did it all with minimal impact on the environment. The technology Lexus is using could get us there, but there's one big thing holding us back.
The major obstacle to that is the fact that we have not as yet found superconductors that will superconduct at room temperature. If we could find or make room temperature superconductors, it would certainly revolutionize transportation. You could easily get levitating cars.
You could have levitating bikes.
Trains.
Maybe you could even have a broom and play Quidditch like Harry Potter.
Flying is different than levitating above a magnetic track, so Harry Potter and Quidditch is not going to happen as a result of this technology.
Okay, but we would all have hoverboards, right?
We would definitely have hoverboards, yeah, that's not it. They still wouldn't work on water, and the roads would have to be made out of metal. But we would definitely have hoverboards.